हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हैप्पी मॉर्निंग। क्लास 12 फिजिक्स यूनिट 6 रे ऑप्टिक्स कंटिन्यूएशन वीडियो। इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रिफ्रैक्शन इन प्लेन सरफेसेस। हियर आफ्टर लेट वी सी द रिफ्रैक्शन इन स्पेरिकल सरफेसेस। ओके, स्पेरिकल सरफेस इट इज़ अ वन दैट विल बी ए पार्ट फ्रॉम द स्पीयर। ओके, स्पेरिकल सरफेस इज ए पार्ट फ्रॉम द स्पीयर, दैट इज नथिंग बट ए कर्व्ड सरफेस। ओके, for that curved surface also the law of refraction will be good. First of all, I consider a spherical surface. Okay, here this is a pole of the spherical surface, this is a principal axis. Okay, this is a center of curvature of the spherical surface. If suppose there is an object here, light from the object that fall on the spherical surface, at that point of instance we have to draw a normal. Okay, for this spherical surface first of all we need to draw a tangent. On the tangent we drawn a line that is perpendicular to the tangent. Okay, that is known as normal. Okay, this normal will meet at a point in a principal axis, that is known as center of curvature. Okay, always the normal pass through the center of curvature of the spherical surface. Okay, here this is a basic to understand the lens. Okay, while studying with the refraction in single spherical surface we need to assume two things. Okay, first one, that is the instant light will be monochromatic. Instant light will be monochromatic. Monochromatic, that means single color light. Then second point, here for this the instant light is very close to the principal axis, that is all the rays will be a paraxial ray. Okay, instant light is very close to principal axis. That means paraxial ray. Okay, then the sign convention that are you already followed in the spherical mirror except focal length. I will say what about the focal length. Okay, then our next topic, that is the equation for single spherical surface. Okay, equation for refraction at a single spherical surface. Here I consider two transparent media with the refractive index n1 and n2 that are separated by a spherical surface. Okay, here this is that spherical surface that separate two transparent media. Here it is n1, here it is n2. The condition is refractive index of the second medium is greater than refractive index of the first medium. Okay, here this is a center of curvature, that is C. This is a pole of the spherical surface. If a line joining the pole and the center of curvature is known as principal axis. Okay, this is known as principal axis. If suppose I am placing a point object, okay, this is the object O, the light from the object that made to fall on a spherical surface, at that point I drawn a normal. Okay, at that point I drawn a normal that will pass through center of curvature. We know the normal will pass through the center of curvature. Okay, this is the angle of incidence I. Here the ray of light travel from rarer to denser medium, so it will bend towards the normal. Okay, after refraction it will bend towards the normal. At that point we can trace the image of the object. Okay, so it is a object distance u, here it is a image distance, that is v. Here from the pole to the center of curvature, that is known as radius of curvature r. Okay, here it is angle of incident, it is angle of refraction. Okay, here there will be a refraction at the point n. Okay, there is a refraction at the point n, so here I am applying Snell's law in product form at the point n. Refraction at n, then apply Snell's law. In product form, that is n1 sin I is equal to n2 sin r. Okay, here the angle of incidence and angle of refraction is very small, so I consider sin I is equal to I and sin r is equal to r. So the equation became, that is n1 I is equal to n2 r. Consider this one as equation 1. Okay, then I am giving a name to the particular angle, that is angle NOP, that is alpha, and then angle NCP, that is beta, then NIP, angle NIP is equal to gamma. Okay, here it is alpha, it is beta, it is gamma. Okay, here once again I repeat the diagram. This is a pole, this is the center of curvature, here this is an object, that is O, ray from the object. At that point I drawn a normal that will pass through the center of curvature. This is angle of incidence I. It will refract and meet at a point in principal axis, that is I. Okay, here I, this one is mentioned as alpha, this was mentioned as beta, here this is mentioned as gamma, this is point N. Okay, this is U, this is V, this is R. Okay, for this case, first of all, I consider a right angle triangle. Okay, what are the right angle triangles in that figure? Okay, first of all, I consider a right angle triangle. Right angle triangle, that is NOP, then NCP, then NIP. See, NOP, right angle triangle, NCP, right angle triangle, NIP, right angle triangle. Okay, for that right angle triangle, I have to consider the tan theta. First of all, I consider NOP, NOP, for that tan alpha, that is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. Here opposite side is PN, adjacent side is PO. Then tan beta, for the triangle NCP, that is equal to PN by, that is PC. Then tan gamma, here that for the triangle NIP, tan gamma is equal to opposite side, that is PN, then the adjacent side will be PI. Okay, see, here the angles are, this alpha, beta, gamma are very small, so I consider tan alpha is equal to alpha, tan beta is equal to beta, then tan gamma is equal to gamma. Okay, then it became alpha is equal to Pn by Po, beta is equal to Pn by Pc, then gamma is equal to Pn by Pi. Okay, then next I consider the triangle ONC. Okay, ONC, see, this is the triangle ON, that is C. Okay, here this no, this is alpha, this is I, and this is beta. Okay, for the triangle we know the summation of the triangle will be 180 degree. Okay, here I need the value of I, that's why this angle can be written as 180 minus I, 180 degree minus I. Okay, so we can write the summation of the angles in a triangle will be 180, that is equal to alpha plus beta plus 180 minus I. On solving this, 180 180 cancelled, then we get I is equal to alpha plus beta. Okay, then next I am considering the triangle, that is INC. Okay, INC, here it is N, it is I, then it is C. Okay, INC, this is gamma, this is R. Okay, angle of refraction R. This we know, this is beta. So this angle can be written as 180 minus beta. Okay, we know the summation of the triangle will be 180, that is equal to R plus gamma plus 180 minus beta. Then 180 going to cancel, then we get beta is equal to R plus gamma. We need R alone, then R is equal to beta minus gamma. Okay, substituting this I and R in the equation 1, we know the equation 1, that is N1 I is equal to N2 R. Substitute here, then N1 I became alpha plus beta, that is equal to N2 R, beta minus gamma. Okay, then solving this, then we get N1 alpha plus N1 beta is equal to N2 beta minus N2 gamma. Okay, again rearranging it, then we get N1 alpha minus this term will be coming this side, then it became N2 gamma. Then we can write, take this N1 beta onto the right side, then we can write N2 beta minus N1 beta. Taking beta as common, then N2 minus N1 beta, that is equal to N1 alpha plus N2 gamma. Then next, substitute the values of alpha, beta and gamma in this equation. Okay, substitute alpha, beta and gamma in the above expression. Okay, then it became N1 alpha, that is Pn by Po, then N2 gamma is Pn by Pi, that is equal to N2 minus N1, the beta is Pn by Pc. Okay, then the Pn in the left side and the right side will be cancelled, then we get the expression, that is N1 by Po is equal to plus N2 by Pi is equal to N2 minus N1, then divided by Pc. Okay, then next I am following the sign convention. Following sign convention. Okay, here PO, it is a distance from the pole of the spherical surface to the object, that is on the left side. So we can write PO is equal to minus U. PI, that is the distance from the pole to the image, that is on right side. So we can write that is plus V. PC, that is the distance from pole to the center of curvature, that is on right side. So we can consider this one as plus R. Substitute in the above expression, then we get N1 by minus U plus N2 by V, that is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. Rearranging it, then we get N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. Okay. This is the equation for refraction at a single spherical surface. Okay. Equation for refraction at a single spherical surface. Okay. We can apply this expression for any spherical surfaces because we are already applied the sign convention. Okay. If suppose I consider the first medium is a air medium, so N1 became 1 for air medium. Refractive index of air is 1, and then I consider N2 as a refractive index N, then the equation became N by V minus 1 by U, that is equal to N minus 1 by R. Okay. By the knowledge of refraction at a single spherical surface, let me move for the next topic, that is thin lenses. Lenses, it is an optical device that focus or disperse a beam of light. Okay, it is an optical device that focuses or disperse a beam of light by the method of refraction. Okay, here we know lens we are using for the corrections of refractive errors, that are myopia, hypermetropia, presbyopia, astigmatism, that are the refractive errors for human beings. Okay, that can be rectified with the help of concave lenses. Okay, these lenses also used in telescope and microscope, the next cameras. Okay, here we can form a lens by the transparent material. Okay, by the transparent material, one or more transparent material. See, lens is formed by the transparent material that is bound between the two spherical surfaces, or one plane surface and the another spherical surface. Okay, if suppose a lens is formed between the two spherical surfaces, we create a lens like this, or okay, this is a lens that can be made with the two spherical surfaces. Here for this case, there will be two center of curvature. Here this spherical surface create a center of curvature in right side, that is C1. This one will make in this side, that is C2. So there will be a corresponding radius of curvature R2, R1. Okay. The next, if suppose we can make the lenses by a plane surfaces and another spherical surfaces. See, one plane surface, one spherical surface. For this plane surface, the center of curvature will be infinity and the radius of curvature also infinity. But here there is a spherical surface, there will be a center of curvature, that is C or C1. Okay, and also there is a radius of curvature, that is R1. Okay, for these lenses we have to use the same terminologies that are already we followed in the spherical mirrors. the image distance, object distance, image height as h and object height as h dash, that are all we can follow for this thin lenses. Okay, there is a only change in focal length alone. Let me see here. There are two focus, primary and secondary focus. First of all, let me see what is primary focus. That is represented as f1. Okay. Here, primary focus, that is a point where the point source kept to produce a parallel emergent ray to the principal axis. Okay. Primary focus is a point. First of all, I consider a biconvex lens. Okay, this is a biconvex lens. Here there is a object on the principal axis. Okay, the light from the object fall on the lens. After refraction, it pass parallel to the principal axis. That is, by the definition, primary focus. It is a point where the point source kept to produce a parallel emergent ray. These are known as emergent ray, parallel to the principal axis. Okay, primary focus f1 is a point where the point source kept to produce parallel emergent rays. Okay, this is said to be f1. Then for this is a biconvex lens. For a biconcave lens, this is a biconcave lens. Suppose ray of light coming in this direction. Okay, after refraction, it will went parallel. Okay, then the instant rays are appear to be converge at a point. Okay. That point is known as f1. See, this is known as biconvex lens, or it is also known as converging lens. This is diverging lens. For converging lens, this object will be a real object. Okay, this object is real object. For diverging lens, this object will be virtual object. Okay, then secondary focus. That is said to be F2. Secondary focus, that is a point where all the parallel rays traveling close to the principal axis converge to form a image on the principal axis. Okay, here I consider a biconvex lens, that is a converging lens, principal axis. Here rays are coming parallel to the principal axis. After refraction, it will merge at a point. That means it converge at a point. At that point, we get an image. Okay, this is known as, this point is known as secondary focus. Okay, the point where all the parallel rays traveling close to the principal axis and form and are it converge at a point on the principal axis. That point is known as secondary focus. This is for converging lens. And this image is known as a real image. And for the diverging lens, biconcave lens, a ray parallel to the principal axis after refraction. Okay. It bend its path in this direction. Then converging it at a point, there will be an image. Okay. That image is virtual image. Okay, this is known as secondary focus. Primary focus, it is a point where all the parallel rays primary focus, here it is a point. So the source is kept at a point where the emergent rays parallel to the principal axis. Here secondary focus, that means there is a point where all the parallel rays that will be converged at a point in the principal axis. That is known as secondary focus. Okay.